des mers, là-bas sous le ciel clair, il existe une cité au séjour enchanté. Et sous les grands arbres noirs, chaque soir, vers le s'en va tout mon espoir. J'ai deux
amours. Didn't have, you know, quite what I needed and where I wanted to get to. So I was about to give up. I was about to give up completely on theater and just deal with psychology. I deal with psychoanalysis and literature, and that's it. And lo and behold,
the man we've been asked to speak about, Pat Maddy, Professor Maddy. And I found Maddy, and that's where all the doors open. That's where everything clicked. The heart, the nature of everything. And I spoke to you earlier about when we deal with what is German culture, it's just something definitive. It's something that's just readily available on sight, on sound, from the way that people walk, talk, the songs that I sing, the traditional songs, the folk songs, all of these things, the poems. You understand what I'm saying? It's in everything. We can see these things being identified, defined by Goethe, Wagner, and up to Bertolt Brecht. Right, when we go into English culture, British, what is Elizabethan theater? We have Shakespeare. These things are easily, readily definable. They're there. The way the people dress, walk, talk, and the song, and the poetry, and all of these things. Professor Maddy is that for Africa. Right? And the way that we define our very gesture, right? When you're talking about theater, you're talking about gesture. What is African gesture? That's Professor Maddy is that man who defines what that is. He is the house.
Mm-hmm.
He is the African house of theater. He does it in a way, no disrespect to any of the men, he does it in a way where a Wole Soyinka could not.
Mm-hmm.
Right? He does it in a way, you know, where Chinua Achebe cannot. These are literary men. These are men who wrote books. Right? Mm-hmm. As I'm reading the book, I have to use my mind. If I'm not in Africa, if I'm not in anything, my only connection to it is the man. You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Pat Maddy could bring something to them, you know what I mean, to the world instantly. You understand what I'm saying? In a dance. You know what I mean? With a dance and a drum, he could display to you what Africa is. It's something definitive. It's not willy-nilly. That's the importance of this man. I had to learn style immediately, right? Because I came out of psychology, I came out of philosophy, came out of basketball, came out of athletics. I didn't come as an art kid, so I was ripped by Cedric Ward, the founder of the Robeson Players, on style. He would say continuously to me, "Who am I going to get to say this shit?" So I had to make it good quick.
Mm-hmm.
Pat Maddy did something else. He taught me what it meant to write like an African, right? It's not something that's willy-nilly. It's something that's definitive. It's something that can be taught over and over again. Cultures on all sides, we have all these old dudes. We call them elders, we call them babas. What are they called?
In mine, we call them, I don't know, like...
The old masters, the old griots,
We call them, it's just different. I guess it's especially, like I was mentioning, we were talking about, like, I was raised within the witch doctors, and those were, like, curanderos, you know, like, and there was so much respect with these guys, because they know medicine, they know even, like, just, they were really respected within the culture.
These are the keepers of the culture. Now... me, just coming from my household, I told you I was raised by, I had a tough father, had to be perfect all day. I can do it all day, but I told you, I still live with the pain of everybody around me. I know you're going to fail, you know what I'm saying? That's just a matter of time. Cedric Boy was very tough.
Mm-hmm.
So when I got to my daughter, he had I'd gone through a whole list of men, starting from my father, just tough.
Mm-hmm.
So I could bear the heat that they had. when a lot of people could not. I could stand there and take the teacher. Pat Maddy was all of that times 10.
I was with Pat Maddy at that time. We were right before and at the time where Dolores Cross had him head up the theater department, the oldest college in the AU in Atlanta. Being Morris Brown, never had a theater department. Mm-hmm. It's absolutely wild. So if you were a student at Morris Brown, you had to go to Spelman, you had to go to, you know what I'm saying? Morris Brown never had a theater. So, you know, all the things that happened with Dolores Cross, whatever, but she chose Pat Maddy to head up the department. I was his assistant in doing that. The atmosphere of rehearsals were that of a battleground. You could lose your life there. You could lose your life there. My job instantly was one of like triage, right? I had to do it quick too because there were people that go running and screaming and crying out of the. It was that serious, and him running right after. I'm like, yeah, man, this with his beret and ascot. So. My job was like triage. It was a matter of priority. So I had to identify immediately who to keep and who just keep running, right? So if you could stay and if you could take the heat of Professor Maddy, what he gave you, what he gave me, you know what I'm saying? We still don't know the outcomes. It's still there. And that's the whole thing about Professor Maddy. It's not something that I can celebrate. You know what I'm saying? It's not something I can celebrate. It's not any of those things. For me, it's more of an acknowledgement of who and what he was, all right? And just going along with the work, just making it a part of the work and going forward with it. And that's basically all I have to say on that. And I mean, the legacy of Pat Maddy is in me. If it ain't nowhere, it's in me, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, everybody that he touched, all the students, everybody, you just have to make it real. It's not doing nothing in a book. It's not doing nothing on a, you have to move it. So that's all, man. So love, bless everybody. Here, Nadia, I love you. Victoria, Maddy family, Maddy stars. We're not students, yo, we're stars. You hear me? So, yo, bless up everybody. Here, peace.